Welcome to WebStylePress. If you are new here, consider subscribing and hit bell icon. I will give you very specific small piece of code to detect and differentiate between mobile device and desktop device. If it's mobile device, our code will add a class named as is-mobile in body tag. If it's desktop device, then a class named as not-mobile will be added to body tag. So you will have a class is-mobile or not-mobile in your web page in body tag, and what you do with it is up to you. What I do with it, I am going to share. I target web page elements to make them responsive according to these classes. These classes show me whether my page is being viewed at desktop, laptop, or mobile device. Let's say I have a menu. A menu should be visible at desktop screen or above 1024 pixels screen in normal scenarios. iPad starts from 1024 pixels, right? And it should change into mobile menu. Our menu should change into mobile menu below 1025 pixels screen. Or if Retina ready device is being used to display our web page. Retina device usually means that its iPhone or iOS is being used to display the page. So very much basic test, but very useful. I use it in almost every project. And this script detects the window resize event as well. The classes will change without page refresh. So let's start. We have covered a device detection script before this tutorial. If you haven't watched that, I will recommend to watch it. This script is that script's basic form. This script is simpler from that script. So as usual, we have got index.html page. So here is our snip for HTML page. And I will use custom.js because I will type my custom scripts in custom.js, and I will need a jQuery as usual. So here's the jQuery CDN link from cdnjs.com, and this is custom.js, and I won't need this text here. And then this, all of this is also going away. I don't need this, and that's WebStylePress, and let's comment it. WebStylePress, yes, spellings are correct. Okay, so jQuery and custom.js. So this is our custom.js. Okay, so our function, we will create a function here. Function, and the name should be screen check. So the screen will be checked whether it's mobile or desktop. Simple. All right, so here is the var device agent, and it's the navigator dot user agent dot to lowercase. All right, so hold on, let's go here. This is our page. Let's go in the console, and yeah, okay, so here's some information: Windows NT and Mozilla, Apple WebKit, Chrome, Safari. Alright, here is some information for this. Okay, so navigator user agent to lowercase. Alright, So we will need another variable here, and agent ID is equal to device agent. We will use this one dot match. We will match this. iPhone or iPad or iPod. Okay, so this is our agent ID. So if agent ID device agent, that is this one dot match iPhone, iPad and iPod. If it is iPhone or iPad or iPod, if agent ID, if it's true, or if this statement is true, if the device is iPhone or iPad or iPod or window dot width is smaller or equal to 1024 pixels. So this statement means that if it's iPhone or iPad or iPod, or if window width or viewport's width is smaller or equal to 1024, you can change it to your liking. I am using 1024, then it's the mobile screen. And here goes mobile code here. Whatever code you want to put for a web page to show in the mobile, that will go here. Or else, in the else case, here is the desktop screen, and code for desktop goes here. So there's a, so this is the mobile area and this is the desktop area. Okay, so here we will add or remove our class. We will get the body. This is the selector jQuery. It means this is dollar sign or jQuery. You can also write jQuery. So jQuery or dollar sign body. This is the body. We selected a tag. We selected body tag. This is how we select stuff in jQuery. So body dot add class. So because this is mobile area, we will add our mobile class. So is dash mobile. Okay, and this is chaining. We are chaining. Okay, we could write like this, and here we have to remove class not mobile. We could write like this, but I am chaining it. First I am adding the class and then I am removing another class in single statement, in single line instead of two lines. Okay, so first select the body and add class is mobile for this area, and remove class not dash mobile if it has got not dash mobile class. Okay, and then I will copy it, and for the desktop area I will come here and I will add class, I will just revert it. I will just remove this class for desktop area. Remove class is mobile, and add class not mobile. And that's it. This is our screen check function, and we will use this function in document dot ready function. When DOM will be ready, then we will use this, then we will call this function, then we will invoke that function, and then also we will use window on resize function, and then we will call this function again. So let's try this, let's give it a go. So refresh the page. As you can see, we have got this class not mobile here, because this is desktop, of course. This not mobile at the border, right? Not mobile. So as we change the viewport, this class will change right here. Not mobile, is mobile. Not dash mobile, is dash mobile. Not dash mobile, is dash mobile. Right, and 1024, it is mobile. 1025, it is not mobile. So basically, this is the class. Basically, where is the iPad? This is the iPad. So for iPad, this is mobile. And this is still is mobile for iPad. And then this is mobile, not mobile. Right, you get the idea, right? So at 10.24 and below, or below that, we will have a class in the body tag that will be is mobile, is dash mobile. And for desktop, we will have a class in the body not dash mobile. Amazing, right? Use it. I hope you like this video. If I missed anything, comment down below. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to this channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media, links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.